All right, YouTubes. Some days you just get jobs to recover units, like where they're doing construction and remodels. So today's job is to just recover a mini split. Mini split air conditioner so they can demo out a wall. I'll bring you guys along for the journey. And we'll get up on this roof and we'll do the magic. There's some old maintenance records. Replace transformer pulley shaft bed. All the way back to 2021, look at that. Maintenance. Okay, that's a little unit back there, the Sanyo. We got some Yorks, some trains, little mix match up here. Like big old solar farm back there. Yeah, that thing. That's cool. We're gonna go fishing expedition with our fishing hook. And there's our stuff down there. Get the nerd in the tank. Let's see if we can hustle up some fishing. All right, believe it or not, I just fished both of those by myself with this hook. Now, Klein Tools makes this hook. There it is. This is made by Klein. Don't look at my chicken shit knot because it's probably not professional, but. So Klein Tools makes this, you can order it. And I was able to go down all the way down there and fish up the goodies solo, so it's pretty good. So now we'll take some of this stuff. I'll put the camera away and we'll take a bunch of this stuff over there. It's an old Sanyo, little mini split. I just checked the label. It's R410A, 2.87 pounds. Got my adapter, so you know when you work on mini splits, you got to have the 5/16 quarter inch adapter. Let's get gauged up. Let's zero this out. All right, we're zeroed. 2 pounds shouldn't take too long. Well, almost 3 pounds. Let's see if there's even anything in it. Yeah, she's got gas in her. Good. All right, low side hooked up, gauge is closed. Come out of our gauges to our inlet on the nerd. Mr. Nerd. This has been a great recovery machine. If you guys don't know the backstory on this recovery machine, Greaves sent that over from NAVAC. And I was using the field piece, Mr. 45. This absolutely smokes Mr. 45, in my opinion. Sorry about that field piece. And I think this one has double condensers. It's been a great recovery machine. I absolutely love this machine. If I had to get another machine, I'd get another NAVAC recovery machine. I like it. Actually, everything NAVAC. So I only have two NAVAC things. They sent me this, and they sent me that battery-operated vacuum pump. And I kind of whined about that you needed a bunch of more batteries for that vacuum pump. But after further review, that little vacuum pump's solid. Seems like most of their stuff's pretty good. All right. Low side into the gauges, out of the gauges, into the inlet, out of the outlet, to the tank. I always like to fill it up on the liquid side. A lot of people like to drop it on the vapor side, flip the tank upside down. That's fine. We all have our own ways of doing stuff. We could probably gravity feed a bunch of refrigerant just by doing this. See? Transferring, even without the machine. So, a lot of these old roofs, there is no electricity. So I'm gonna try and scab some power if possible and see if we can hook up the old Humper the Jumper cord. A lot of people call these a suicide cord, jumper cord. I know that one's got power for sure. It's running right now. And I do have my big long 100 footer here. So let me work on that and we'll tune back in.
I'm gonna go scabbing power on a commercial roof. You gotta check voltage. Like, these units are 460 volts. Uh-oh, come on, iPhone, focus. 460 volt units.
You're not scabbing power off a leg of those. So, and the problem is the Sparky's demoed out a bunch of this already. So, we'll see what we can come up with here. He might have to work his magic for me. All right, had to run. It's a good thing I got a ton of cords, even for a refrigeration guy. So, plugged in. I got my 100 footer. Had to go get the 25. We'll be able to recover this. Now, newer buildings, you'll have 110 service on the roof and you'll have hose spigots. Because over time, they've learned that you have to, you gotta service your rooftop units. So you'd like to have a water spigot up here and 110, a bunch of them stationed. Those condensers down there are running. That's cool. There's one day I used to service that building when I worked for the mechanical contractor. That was one of our accounts up there. I saw him install that solar farm and I saw a big old mountain lion right there going to that house one morning. Big old hogger. It's pretty neat. All right, we got power. Let's recover. All right, that's half the battle. Look, we got power. Let's do it. Let's sucker dry. Dude, it's funny. I got most of it static. That's incredible. I had that tank pulled into a big old deep vacuum. Let's see, we're at zero. Now there's nothing gauged up on the high side. We're only gauged up on the low side. So let's take our way down. What's cool about this machine, it'll get all the way down and turn itself off. It's the nerd.
Yep, the nerd, NRDD. Digital DC recovery unit.
Been a good one.
There we go. Look at that. Negative six.
Look at that's the right eyebrow vent. So water can't get back down the roof. Good stuff. And that's pretty much it for recovery. I mean, it's, you know, the weather's cooperating. You know, you get big units, you got to pull 60, 50 pounds out. You need big tanks, you're going to be there all day. And a lot of times you got to cool the tank off, put it in a bucket of ice or get a subcooler, a bunch of coiled up copper and put that in water or ice water. Tricks. This is just a basic little recovery. They're going to demo out the wall that the indoor unit's on. And I don't know if they're going to reuse this thing or not. They're going to figure it out later. But that was just to kind of show you, you know, get your morning workout in. I love this job. Don't you guys love doing HVAC and refrigeration? You could be getting an old bastard like me, you know, getting up there. What am I now? How old am I now? 56 now. Still humping every day. And at work, that is, anyways. And you gotta love it. Especially when you get a nice morning like this. Storm just blew through. And just a great career, you know? I will say, I did commercial refrigeration for a long time, and then
I worked for a mechanical contractor for 10 years. And doing the rooftop units, I really enjoyed it. As you get older, dude, the refrigeration racket, I mean, it gets to be a bit. And then doing the, look at all these rooftop units. So you think Santa Cruz, oh, Santa Cruz, mild climate. Yeah. There's air conditioning everywhere, people. Heating and air. Look, mini split hell. Look at all the VRVs over there. VRV Central, mini split centrals. I mean, that's where it's going, the future. Look, there's some old carriers. Those ones had the old three-wire pilot. Remember those? Green, white, yellow. Those things are still alive and kicking. Let's zoom in on those. Those two beauties right there. Three-wire pilot. No inducer motor. Old school. You got the old school and the new school. There it is. VRV. Oh, God. Samsung's, too. And look, you got a mixed match. Like Bryant. There's Bryant, Samsung, York, Sanyo, Carrier. The smorgasbord. And then we got this. Oh yeah, coming way down. Let her rip her on down.